The incomparable Canon AE-1, so advanced, it's simple. Canon.
Hey there guys, what is up? It's me, Riley, and very recently, my good friend Kevin had his 18th birthday. For his birthday, I decided to get him a film camera, since he'd shown some interest in me and my doings with film in the past, and so I scoured Craigslist for a good point-and-shoot camera, and I found this one Nikon One Touch 100 for sale, which seemed to have a pretty good lens and a pretty cool body, and seemed to be a really good, solid point-and-shoot. So I contact this guy, get his information. Mind you, it was raining in California during this period of time. Like, it was really raining. And to make matters worse, the car was out of commission, so I had to take the bus over to our meetup location, which was an interesting adventure in and of itself. But once I got there, he showed up relatively quickly, handed me the camera without much fanfare. As I was heading home, I just couldn't resist the irresistible lure of the camera sitting there on the bench next to me, and I obviously kind of fiddled around with it, but I just loved the way it felt in my hands, and the mechanism and the lens and everything about it just screamed filmy sex appeal. And Kevin, if you're watching this, I'm sorry, your camera's a little more used than you initially anticipated. I ran home and I ran a roll of HP5 through it, and well, here are the results. The very first thing I did was fix the faulty back door by putting a little spring underneath the mechanism and sealing up all the little cracks with gaffer's tape to try and cover up any light leaks the camera might have. The cracks were just relatively large, and that combined with the faulty door was making me a little anxious. This camera produces super sharp images, like wicked sharp considering the conditions I put it through. My hands were shaking, I was shooting one-handed as I was walking towards this person who was walking towards me. So the fact that anything was in focus in that shot was a miracle. Unfortunately, there was no flash override, so I ended up Bruce Gildening a couple people, but I eventually got the hang of it when I realized that the little red light goes on whenever the flash wants to activate, and was able to get a couple of candids without blowing out people's corneas. Did I mention this camera feels really good in the hands? Because who does it feel good in the hands? Fantastic weight, size, just feel for carrying around for hours on end. Oh yeah, and this thing has an automatic flash, and boy does it like to use it. I have an image or two that I took of it where it used the flash, and you can tell from this comparison image I took with my iPhone that that really wasn't flash-worthy lighting, but I digress. In the end, I'm very impressed. This camera surpassed every single last one of my expectations that I had placed upon it. The images came back super sharp considering the garbage conditions I put it through. It had a fantastic workflow to it, and I'm happy with a lot of these images that I got back, considering the fact that I was kind of being a crappy photographer and just trying to get a bunch of test shots out. This camera held up its end of the deal quite well. I personally think this camera would be great for literally anyone who doesn't have it. Seriously, I love it. I think it would be great for people who know nothing about film photography and are looking for an in. So Kevin, you're gonna love this camera. Someone like me who shoots with primarily SLRs, this is gonna be a really fun point and shoot, which won't let me and my shaky hands down. And point and shoot aficionados, if you do not have this camera, it's not that expensive. This camera has a lot of cost value ratio inside its little plasticky 80s body. Anyways guys, that's it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it wholeheartedly. What did you think of the film camera review? Was it interesting to you guys? Do you think it's a good way for me to express my love of film photography on my YouTube channel? And film photographers who are watching this, how'd I do? Leave a comment down in the comment section below. I would love to hear your constructive criticism. Everyone stay positive and have an awesome day.